YouTube, welcome back to another Log Game video, and today we are in our week 4 connected franchise game, and we're playing Pyro, you know, Pyrex Rising. Hopefully most of you guys know him. He is the Steelers and I am my Baltimore Ravens, as he drops a user pick off a warp that was end up huge because the next play Crockett Gilmore takes it to the house as we go up 7-0. And he just wide open field right there. But yeah, Pyro came in the game. Everybody said he was gonna win. As he drops the pass right there with my user skills. I can't even lie. I was a little intimidated coming in this game because everybody was like, you know, Pyro was so good and everything. And you know, kind of scared me as Terrell Suggs off the edge with the sack. Now he's got 3rd and 20, just trying to do some stuff. But yeah, Pyro. Pyro is he's a good player. He's a really good player. You know, he made a stupid mistake right here as he's Tavon Young, the rookie for Baltimore, gets a pick, making a great showing in the season so far. And then, you know, Flacco with the wheels. So so this is my first time playing Pyro, and I was a little scared because he was overhyped a little bit. No, don't get me wrong, Pyro is good. He's really good. I don't know, I didn't really learn his scheme yet, as he A-glitches as a touchdown away from me. But, I was trying to, like, learn his scheme throughout the whole game, and it's kind of hard to get where he was going. I did notice he has some really good run defense, and doesn't run no, like, cheesy defense. As we, go up 14-0 right there. That was huge for us. So, I'm coming out the gates, you know, flooding him. And I'm like, this guy is not even that good. But, you know, Pyro, he's actually really good. And he just got unlucky right there as this lineman falls on top of the ball. And he still didn't get it. And we ended up recovering. But, that wouldn't really matter too much for Pyro. But, you know, we're just trying to get in the end zone here. Go up 3 scores, hopefully. And that would be huge as Steve Smith decides to win back. So, also 3 right there. And we're fine with taking our 3 right here. But we're going to search around the pocket. Flacco rolling out. And right here, my guy, well, Flacco just got across the line, and I was going to throw it away, but it said he was across the line, so Pyro's going to take it all the way back. But wait, Perryman with the speed tackles him at the 13-yard line. So that's how that the halftime ends right there. Now Pyro gets the ball, and now trying to get his first score of the game as he's shut out in the first half. That was good defensive start for me. And offensive too, except for that ending. As he throws it right over my user, and then he just breaks a couple tackles. I don't know how that wasn't user picked. I was heated. I don't know. It was a good throw by Big Ben though. Good dot, even though Tavon in the same situation earlier. And look, I tried baiting him right there with Ladarius Webb. If I was a half a second earlier, that might have been picked, but. You know how we do, we get back on offense, we're trying to go down the field and score again. As Flacco rolls out, avoids the sack, and forces it gets hit stick on 3rd and 7. So it's going to be 4th and inches, and we're going to roll out with the wheels again, and we get the first down. So the one thing I have realized is I like to utilize Flacco's legs, because he can actually run. Now everybody sleeps on that. Now I will take off with Flacco. See, but he rushed 2 right there, and that's what made me mad, is he rushed 2 people, and he still got me. He kept on running QB contain on me, because he, like I said, he knew Flacco could run. And, I just wasn't utilizing it as much as I should have. But I'm smart about my run plays. If I have short yards to go, I'm definitely considering running the ball at Flacco. Or even, you know, running the ball in general. But, you know, Pyro trying to tie up the game right here. He throws it deep to Antonio Brown, the best receiver. And he goes against the best corner, and the best corner gets it. Jimmy Smith right there with a huge pick. Now we're just going to try to run up this clock. I've yet to score in the fourth, or the second half, for that matter, as we find another 4-set open. Excuse me. And like we just said, just chewing the clock off, trying to waste as much time as possible. And we reposition 4-set. He tries clicking on at the last second. We get the first down, so that's huge. 2-minute warning. Now Pyro needs to stop desperately. And now I'm still passing the ball because Pyro's rush defense is really good. I couldn't really do anything, but he can't stop Forsett right there. And we end up getting the first down, and he's just got two timeouts left, and we're just going to need out. And we end up getting the win against Paro somehow. So make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and I'm out.